I'm Emily Persley, Chair of the Bicentennial Committee. Pike County was established in 1821, and since then we have had 5 courthouses. The first one was a small log cabin in what is today Calhoun County. The second one was in our second county seat, which was in Atlas. The third one, which was in our third county seat in Pittsfield, was this one. This was on the north side of the square in Pittsfield. This one was in the center of the courtyard where the current one is today. And this one was built in 1894, completed and dedicated in 1895. And here is an invitation to the dedication on November 16th in 1895.
New security implemented this year, actually, and now when you come from ground floor, the elevator will only come to first floor, and you will be checked in, and then a guard will release it for you to go to any floor you'd like. Now, if you leave the building, the elevator will take you anywhere you want to ground floor and out. So you don't have to go through the guard again, but you will always come to first floor. We implemented this security because we knew it was coming. The state was going to mandate all courthouses have metal detectors and security anyway, so we just tried to beat it to the punch. This design was less intrusive than the other plans we had, building on or modifying somewhere else. You walk in that front door and you're checked into a guard. And as you leave, you go to the other side, to the right, and not be involved in anyone coming in. We're securing this door way right here to the basement. It will be sealed up with a door, basically. Like this door right here, it'll look just like that when we're done. It's more that way if anybody were to overrun the guard, they could run down the stairs and get to wherever they wanted to. That'll eliminate that issue. And we always knew that with most places where tragedy happens, it's not if it happens, it's when. And before we have an instance, we implemented the security protocol. My name is Darwin Feenstra, and I am the maintenance supervisor in the Pike County Courthouse in Pittsfield, Illinois. And this is my courthouse, as they say. This is actually the 5th courthouse for Pike County. It is the 2nd in this spot. this pillar wheel light, my understanding, that has always been in here, and I don't know what year it started. This isn't the original light, but when I started, there wasn't one 7 years ago. So I got to asking around about it and found out that from the last maintenance man, he always kept them repaired, but after a while he couldn't find parts or lights anymore, so he just gave up. Well, I put an ad in the paper and asked several people and got got one donated for me, and that's where this one comes from. So now, and if it ever fails again, I guess I'll ask for another donation. When this was being built, just like today, they have trouble getting new supplies, and they had a lot of trouble getting stone and stuff here. There was a family that lived in Nebo, Franklin, and they came. Robert Franklin came in to pay his taxes, which is where the Red Dome building is now. It was Red Dome, and that's why the work had stopped. And they said they didn't have a keystone mason to continue the outside work, but you see the ornamental work. And he said, well, that's what I do that. And my brother and our sons and our family, we do that. So they hired him. And it's because of him that it got finished when it was supposed to. It was on a 400-day contract, and they didn't need it. But because of them, they were able to finish it. And these are his tools. This is our downstairs judges' chambers, and we had a water leak one time, which is repaired and ruined plaster. We decided to knock back what we could to see what was good and bad, and before we knew it, we had pretty much all that off of there. Had an inmate come from jail, and we decided that instead of trying to replaster it, we just stripped it down with a bare brick, water sealed it, and it came out really pretty. You'll notice as you walk out this door that the color of the wood is so much different in here than in this hallway. I wasn't here when this was done, but in the 1 year they brought inmates over and they completely stripped this whole downstairs first floor down to the oak and then just revarnished it. It really came out pretty. It's got a blonde color to it. We would like to do the whole building, but it's kind of hard right now with not letting anyone in the courthouse. I think they need to. We had a tree in an elm tree in the corner, one of the corners of the courthouse, and it was, I believe, 150 years old when it finally died. And Henry Kingery made a dulcimer from it. And a slab of it is in the East School Museum. And this bench was also made from that same wood. This is the upper courtroom. It would normally seat around 450 people, but we don't use our gallery anymore. First of all, we don't seat that many people who come in for cases, and there was no use for it. And it has such a low railing that OSHA wouldn't let us use it anyway, unless we modify it. It's pretty much all the same it used to be. Most of the seats have been repadded. The jury box seats are different from the original, but all the seats downstairs are original. Judge's bench is original. Recorder over to the left there, that used to be on the front of the judge's bench. It was moved at some point. We had a really bad water leak a few years. Wasn't attended to, but we had that fixed last year. The gutters were supposed to be, they're a trough shape, square box gutter. And I don't know what they're originally made of, but we tore out everything and they put back in leaded covered copper and they soldered everything together and rubbered it, and we are good to go. So now we have to start our repairs when money becomes available, which is hard because of all the other ongoing expenses with the building this old. So donations are greatly appreciated. braces were put in an afterthought. When it was being built, the public kind of complained about it, didn't think it looked strong enough. Base didn't look big enough for the height. So Henry Elliott was the architect who built this. So they brought in another architect from Chicago, and I can't remember his name, to survey it. And he did say that, yes, it's okay for now, but it won't hold. It's not strong enough. It's dangerous, and we basically could condemn it. So they built these turnbuckles, and they go up to the bottom. So it's being held this way, and it's got turnbuckles that if it starts to sag, if this bottom starts to sag, you know, there, if you're man enough, you crank these with a big bar, and you would basically pull from there to there to lift. Jerseyville, same architect, one year newer than this one, 1893, broke a truss in their attic. Wow. Think about that. Fix that. Yeah. Broken truss. Right? Wow. What are you going to push against? You got to hang. I mean, that's just crazy. So they were smart. They were right. But the one thing people don't notice is when you go outside and look at the courthouse, the stone that you see is stone. But once you look up above the roof line and it's a beige color, it looks like stone painted, but it's tin. There's no stone from that roof line up. It's wood and it's got tin. And all them gargoyle little things that hang, not gargoyles, but little things that hang over, they're tin. It's all sealed in tin and soldered shut. They're just little ornaments. There's no stone that they're covering. That's all that design up there and all that intricate work is tin. These little louver windows are open, and I assumed it was so air would, it would come through instead of blowing this off. But I discovered by accident that where that chandelier hung in the courtroom, that is completely open. That's just ornate metal. So all the heat from downstairs would go up through into this attic. You open this door and another door, and this draws everything out of the building, out of the court. It's crazy. You can open all this here and go down and open that front door, and you can feel it drawing in from that front door. So I think this was for ventilation, so you would let the heat out of here in the summer. Now in wintertime, I cover that with insulation, so the heat stays in the courtroom. But we're looking at upgrading that too. The air conditioning is not near enough for that courtroom. Lock that door shut. That's probably a 800 pound door. It's solid, and they cut it open. To dismantle the locking mechanism, I believe. You can't lock it anymore. But I came in one day, and this was shut. And
And I'm thinking, that door should not be shut. You did that. I couldn't get it open. Wedged it into the frame. And I brought the sheriff over here. And I said, what do you want to do? I said, they got to get in there. There's records in there. I go, we'll have to cut these pins off. I go, I don't want any part of that door when it comes loose. And he said, I don't know. Can we get an access outside? I go, no. The windows are all barred from the inside. So, I drilled and tapped that out, screwed it into the door frame, and shut it. Of course, I put this in here so no one can ever lock the door again. It was wedged shut, and I put a pry bar under here and against that with a block of wood, and kept prying it. So I had to have something to pull that wood. I got it. It didn't open. But I keep a block of aluminum in there now, so when this goes shut, this pin right here hits it and goes into that frame. This sword used to hang in the first floor of the courthouse, and it was thought that it was a Civil War sword, and the maintenance guy before me, Burdette Irwin, him and another man made that box to display it. Come to find out, somewhere on there is stamped something else. I'm not sure if it says India or China. But they don't think it's a Civil War sword, so they brought it down here, and this is where it's been ever since.